Hello, it's me, Ender, that one asshole who just disappeared from YouTube for like a year and then uploaded a Warzone video. University took me out of the whole YouTube scene, but I kept looking back at my old Doom Guy video and thinking, yeah, I can do this better. So with Doom Eternal fresh when I had the idea, I wanted to do a redux of the Doom Slayer. With new lore, more toys, and newly fueled appreciation for Doom, I figured I'd put out a video on the anniversary of their old one. Then I figured, screw it, I may as well just do this as soon as I can. So screw it, let's do this. The Doom Slayer is the epitome of badass. He is fast, deadly, and brutal. With the new lore clearing things up just a little bit, I feel like I can make this make a little more sense. Let's start with the basics. This time around, the Doom Slayer is a variant human. We're actually going with standard array stats-wise. If your DM doesn't allow feats, just go normal human and, I guess, don't use crossbows? Either way, if you can't use feats, feels bad, man. Strength's gonna be your highest stat at 16 since you want the most damage out of Doom Guy. Next up is Constitution at 14 since he's one beefy bastard. Dexterity is next, as that's gonna be pretty damn important for ranged combat and armor class, so that's saying is 14 as well. Charisma is next, oddly enough, and while he's not exactly the most friendly or charming of people, he is intimidating as all hell. He's sitting at a 12 for charisma. Wisdom is going to be next at 10, as he seems to know his way around these demons, and I also find wisdom will give you more bang for your buck in general. Granted, since the Codex is prominent in Doom Eternal, you could definitely make an argument for intelligence being higher than wisdom here. However, I leave that up to you, these are both up stats anyways. And speaking of intelligence, this is going to be your dump stat at 8. As far as I'm aware, the Doomslayer doesn't really seem to have much in the way of academic intelligence as he's more of a combative type. However, I can definitely see why you would want to swap the intelligence and wisdom scores. Of course, if you are rolling for stats, this should just give you a general idea of what to prioritize over what. So if you end up with different stats, that's totally okay too. As far as what to put your bonuses from Variant Human in, definitely go into one of the physical types depending on what you roll. So either Strength, Constitution, or Dexterity. Charisma is not bad to put one in as well. Moving on to the other basics, take Crossbow Expert for your Variant Human feat and set your alignment to Chaotic Good. I know the last time I said Doom Guy was Chaotic Neutral, but this doesn't really seem to sit well with current lore. The reason I said he was Chaotic Neutral was because I had assumed that the Doom Slayer and the Betrayer were the same person. This was thankfully clarified in the first few levels of Eternal. Additionally, Doom Guy is a man of the people, not giving a damn if it means saving his own race. He punches a superior to save a few civilians, save Vega from a Mega Delete, right up to, well, that's spoiler territory if you haven't already played Eternal. Hell, you could even make an argument for Doom Guy being lawful good, depending on how you interpret it. Grab the soldier background for its personality traits and skill proficiencies of athletics and intimidation, and I'll have a full list of traits in the description. Now, last time, Doom Guy was a Storm Herald Barbarian with Kensei Monk. Now I realize that's a load of horseshit. This time around, he's a Zealot Barbarian multiclass into Oath of Vengeance Paladin. This combo both makes sense narrative-wise and also gives you plenty of abilities to kick ass with. Now, I know you're looking at that combo and thinking, wait, if he's a Paladin, why does he have a charisma of only 12? And you'd be right. You need a charisma of at least 13 or higher to multiclass into Paladin, so unfortunately, you're going to have to grind through at least 4 levels of Barbarian before you can multiclass into Paladin. Or just start Paladin and get super angry later on? It sucks, but this is a pretty long-run build. So, why these two narrative-wise? Well, the Barbarian is obvious, his power literally comes from his anger, and he was blessed by a Seraphim to become the ass-kicking beast he is. Paladin comes in after he joins up with the Night Sentinels, and the oath is because of the demon slaughter of Daisy, his pet rabbit. Honestly, totally reasonable motive. As far as level combination goes, go with Barbarian 9 and Paladin 11. At 11th level Paladin, you get improved Divine Smite, which applies to all melee attack rolls, including unarmed strikes. Plus, that's not even considering a normal smite for an unarmed strike, and you know what that means! Alternatively, you can go an 8-12 combo and grab all 5 ability score improvements, but you do lose out on the Barbarian's Brutal Critical. Although, honestly, how many times are you going to be rolling crits, really? Skills-wise, there's not a whole lot to choose from. You've got Athletics and Intimidation covered by the Soldier background, and I say grab Perception and Survival, considering you can get a lot of value out of those. For your Variant Human proficiency, you can grab either Investigation, Medicine, or Religion. If you take Paladin for your starter class, grab Insight and Medicine, and then get Investigation or Perception, depending on party needs. Starting equipment is going to be highly dependent on your class, but for the full loadout, go for the following. A Greatsword to make his Crucible, trust me, this will work wonders in conjunction with Smites. a heavy crossbow for his super shotgun, which is always a staple, full plate armor if he started with paladin or snag the heavily armored feat, or half plate if he started with barbarian, a bladed weapon of some sort to act as his arm blade, preferably a short or a long sword, several vials of alchemist fire to act as the flamethrower, a couple of flasks of oil to increase the effectiveness of the alchemist fire, and if he can, grab a ring of spell storing and load it up with shatters and ice knives for the frag and ice grenades. Alternatively, you could use Chromatic Orb or even Ray of Frost for the ice grenades. Here are some feats to look out for. Crossbow Expert, obviously that's going to be one of your main weapons throughout your playthrough. Alert so you can act burst and not worry about surprise. Great Weapon Master if you really want to take advantage of your Crucible. Heavily Armored for if you start as a Barbarian and want that Heavy Armor proficiency. Masteries for both Medium and Heavy Armor, each of which offer great benefits. Mobile for when you need to move fast and avoid opportunity attacks at all costs. And finally, Tavern Brawler for when the flat unarmed damage doesn't quite cut it. Athlete is also worth looking into if you want to lean into the hardcore parkour aspect Doom Eternal brought. So, without going too far into magic items, that's pretty much the new Doom Slayer. Let me know what you think down in the comments, and let me know if there's anything else you guys want to see built. I've also found a lot of recommendations from the older build, so I'll try to build those guys ASAP. Stay frosty, and I'll see you in the next one.